Thank you very much for joining me once again today. I will encourage you to share the program to all your loved ones so that they can also benefit from today's program. As usual, we will be looking at immigration law update in the United Kingdom in respect to decisions that has gone before the court relating to false documentation, especially birth certificates, where Home Office have alleged that the birth certificates were fake. And it's important that we look at false representation and Home Office guidelines in respect to false representation and also documents that they have deemed to be fake. So we'll be looking at that. We will also be looking at, once again, biometric residency permit card for European nationals and their family members. Sometimes there's a bit of confusion as to whether European nationals can actually apply for biometric residency permit card. I will explain that, and also the family members, whether they can apply for settlement scheme biometric residency permit card, and whether it is compulsory, whether there is a need for them to apply. I will do the best that I can and explain this to you once again today. For the past week or so, I have had a lot of telephone conversations with people. And in spite of the fact that we talk about this almost every week, I think there is still confusion out there. I mean, yesterday I spent about 30 minutes explaining it once again to a family. They could not understand why they have applied for settlement scheme. They have been issued with a letter confirming that the application has been successful, but yet they are being told to apply for settlement card. The question that I was being asked is, why is it that the Home Office did not give them the card straight away? I will do the best that I can to explain why that is the case. Also, a case has gone before the Upper Tribunal, and the court has made an interesting observation. Then it's also important that I bring it to your attention, so that you know the update. Just in case you find yourself in such a situation, then at least you have an idea what the law says. Now, there is something called non-binary identity. Non-binary identity, which can be used to form a basis of an asylum application in the UK. So you'll be looking at that as well, what it means by non-binary identity and how it can be used to apply for an asylum in the United Kingdom. I will then also be looking at the 7 years concessionary policy. If your child is being in the UK for 7 years, can you make an application, a successful one, on the basis of having a child who was born in the UK or who has come to the UK and the child has spent 7 years of his life in the UK? So in that respect, we'll be looking at the factors that will make it unreasonably harsh to expect the child and the mother to relocate to another country. We will be looking at that. And then we will then go to the consumer law. Recently there has been cases that people have contacted me. They have purchased items, they have purchased goods and services, and it has transpired that they are no longer interested in those goods and services. The question, therefore, is as to whether they can return those goods in particular without any sanctions. We'll be looking at that as well. And in terms of that, we'll be looking at digital content. There are some stuff that you have to buy it online, and it is digital. And then we'll also be looking at goods bought in a shop. If you buy something from a shop, what is it that you can do? What are your rights under Consumer Rights Act of 2015? We'll be looking at the key points. We will also be looking at goods ordered at home. You are sitting at home and you order the goods, and for whatever reason you don't want it. What are your rights? You'll be looking at the Consumer Contract Regulations of 2013, and we will then also be looking at Consumer Rights Act of 2015. Your right as a consumer. I mean, Christmas is coming up. A lot of people are going to be purchasing services and goods, and you need to know where you stand in an event that the item is faulty, or maybe you don't wish to purchase it anymore. It is important that we talk about this today. So pay attention to what we are going to be talking about. Because sometimes, you know, you can purchase an item for one reason or the other. You may not want the item anymore. A will buy it, B will buy it. But when A returns it, the shop will take it. But when A returns it, the shop may not take it. So it is important that you understand the legality. You know, what the law says must be a good reason in order for you to be able to return your goods and get your money back. Because if you understand the law and you talk right, then of course you'll be able to do what? You'll be able to get your stuff back. So for me, it is very, very, very important that we understand the law. Because when you are returning your goods and you don't say the right stuff, unfortunately, you're not going to get your money back. It's very, very important that we do understand this. Okay, and we will also be looking at services ordered at home. So you have ordered a service at home. You'll be looking at that. And in that respect, you'll be looking at the Consumer Contract Regulations 2013. And we will also be looking at the Consumer Rights 2015. It's very, very important that we look at this. So that is it, really. So today is going to be an interesting day, because there is a bit of everything in it. There's a bit of every in it. So join me, and if you have joined me, let's use the next few minutes to share the program, because I believe that by sharing, it means that you are also caring. Mr. Ishan, thank you very much. If you could also put your details on the comment section for me. Amway Product will be having a chat with you this afternoon. So please do the best that you can. A lot of people were calling me, asking for your details in terms of how to get some of your product. And I am proud to say that Lawyer Darko, I've been very, very fortunate. You should thank this man for me, because his product has done me good. You know, as you can see me on the screen, if I'm looking good, thanks to Mr. Ishan and the Amway product that he has supplied me. You know, he gave it to me for free. And I must say this, and I thank him, I will forever thank him. You know, so, you know, you should all thank him for me. If you want some of the products, get in touch with him and he will sort you out for good. You know, so I appreciate him more. So by all means, Na Onapo, thank you very much for joining us. Share the program for us whilst, you know, we are taking this song. You know, do the best that you can. Share the program to everyone on your contact list so that they can also benefit from today's program. As I speak to you, I'm not looking at the screen because I'm sharing the program. So please also do the best that you can and share the program for us. Madam Francisca Buffwewa, thank you very much for joining us and for sharing the program. All those sharing, we appreciate you and we thank you. Let's use the, you know, first 2 minutes to share the program. Let's get as far as we can. Let's educate the masses. Because by sharing, you are playing your part. You know, let's not keep it to ourselves. Let's share. Because today's program, whether you have papers or you don't have papers, it's important that you know your rights as a consumer of goods and services in the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. So please share the program for us. As soon as you join, you share the program. Let's try and get everywhere. Let's try it and go everywhere. Because today's program, the topic, it does affect everyone. It does affect anyone. Because we are all consumers one way or the other. And today we will also be looking at school attainment. This week there has been a report out about black children doing well at school, at their GCSE, O levels. After A levels, they drop. The question that I'm asking myself is, why is that the case? Whilst it is very easy for people to point out to the obvious about racism in the system, but we also need to look at ourselves. And today, I will intend to rely on symbolic interaction theory to try to explain why our children, when they get to A levels, after O levels, they begin to drop. What I'm going to say, some of it may be controversial, but like I always say, if you hear someone making a comment, as much as you may disagree with what the person is saying, do the best that you can, listen to what the person had to say. There may be one line that can actually answer your question. There may be one line that can actually make sense to you. Like they say, a penny drop. If you go and fetch your own water, you will value every drop. And the lips of the righteous preaches many. So let's do the best that we can. Let's share the program and preach many. Because ignorance is a disease and it is killing our communities. The only way is to educate ourselves. Like they say, education is like numbers. It never ends. You can never stop learning because there is always something to learn. So do the best that you can. Be a partaker of this program. This program is called Legal Matters Emremun Sen, brought to you by Lawyer Dagu of Justice and Law Solicitors in conjunction with Fire Life Radio. Thank you very much once again for joining us. Let's share the program as much as we can. By the time we finish this program, I believe that we will all be blessed. Bye. Yes, now let's get to business. Little Darling, Stir It Up. The original was Robert Nestor Marley. Thank you very much once again for joining us. Today's program, the title or the program is called The Legal Matters, aka Emremu Insem. And we thank God for giving us another day. I hope that you all had a good week. And may Lord God Almighty God continue to bless you all. At the end of the day, life and wisdom is better than silver and gold. Money cannot buy life. And money cannot buy class. As long as you continue to live, you live for the glory of the Most High. We thank you once again for joining us. Today is very, very important that I go back and talk about this again. That is European Union Settlement Scheme visas. and the card. I'm going to take my time and break it down. And I'm going to speak as slowly as I can. Because my friends in the Gambia, thank you very much for tuning in, all the Gambian community. Maria Great Yamov, thank you very much for referring a lot of your people in the Republic of Gambia and Senegal to Justice and Law Solicitors. And we do appreciate you. And all the comments that you have brought, I will also take it on board and in good faith. You know, because at the end of the day, you know, a wise man listens to others and take a leaf from the counsel that he's given. But the fool will always be full of himself and will not listen to any voice of dissent or reason. So I thank you very much. And I will always, you know, make a room to listen to different views and opposing views and, you know, advices, because it can only help you as a human being to be a better person. Like they say, a wise man listens to others, but the fool is full of himself. So for that reason, I thank you. And I am prepared to learn, and I'm prepared because I want to be wise. And I will take any advice, any suggestions that everyone bring on board. So for that reason, today I am going to take my time and speak as slowly as I can so that your community can also, you know, get something valuable from the program that Justice and Law Solicitors through Lawyer Darko that I bring to you. I've been doing this program since 2010. And in fact, it's been 10 years since I have started doing this radio and also, you know, audio and Facebook interactions with you every single week. As long as we continue to live, as long as we are alive, we will all do the best that we can to bring you the legal matters every Saturday. Now, what is the issue? I'm going to take my time again and break it down. As we all know, it wasn't long ago, and the United Kingdom decided to come out of the European Union, which is good, which is bad, depending on the political fence where you sit. For this reason, we voted to come out. And the arrangement is that we are coming out of the European Union on the 31st of December 2020. And we all know that some of our friends, our family members, were colleagues, etc., etc. Because of their marriage to an European national, or because of being a family member, being a mother, being a father, being a cousin, being a brother to an European national, through that relationship, they have been given a visa to stay in the UK with their European family member. And the visa that they have been given is called residency card. This residency card, you will also see that they've written EU family member. And as a family member, EU residency. So that in itself means that you have been given a visa because of your association or because of your relationship with an European national. Normally, once they issue this visa, it's for 5 years. And once you have completed the 5 years as an European national family member, you will then be given something called permanent residency card as an EU family member. That is fine. It's valid and it is recognized in the UK because it has been issued by the UK government. Okay, that is fine. However, as I aforementioned, on 31st of December, we are coming out of the European Union. So what it means is that from 1st of January 2021, the European Union law will no longer be applicable in the UK. EU law will no longer be applicable in the UK. So that means that you can no longer rely on European law. Instead, you'll be relying on British immigration law. So it's for this reason that the government brought in what we call transition. That is transitioning from European Union law to British immigration law. So when we say transition, like traveling, transition, you are moving away from European law to British law. So it is very, very important that we understand this. We are transitioning, we are coming out of the European law to British law. So that means any rights that you have acquired as an European national or a family member of an European national, it has become necessary to also transition your visa from European family permit card, European residency card, permanent residency card to European Union Settlement Scheme card, which it is issued under British immigration law. So the government has been advising people for the past 2 years that any European national and their family members, they must make sure that they apply for settlement scheme card, which through justice and law solicitors, Lawyer Darko and other lawyers, we come on the radio every single day coaching and advising people that in order to avoid problems after we have come out of the European Union, do the best that you can and apply for settlement scheme or pre-settlement scheme status. Once you apply for the settlement scheme or pre-settlement scheme status, two things happens, and this is crucial. We need to understand this. If the UK government has already issued you with a card under European law, and the card, they have written on it, the front page, is very, very important. If you have one, just take a look. Or if you don't understand it, just listen to what I'm saying and look at your card and ask yourself, do you need to apply for the card that I'm just about to talk about? So let's go through it step by step, and hopefully you'll be able to get the understanding. So when we are also explaining it to our brethren and sisters, we are able to give them the accurate and, you know, easy explanation so that they can also understand it. The old card, these are the features of the old card. Right on top of it, they have written residency card. That means European residency card. And in the right corner, they've written your serial number. And then when you come down, just beneath the residency card, they have written your name is there, followed by valid until date. And then you will have place and date of issue. And then you have type of permit in which they will write family member dash EU residence, and then remarks, they will write work permitted, and then they will have your picture on the left hand side and your signature on the right hand side. And right at the bottom, they've written residency card of a family member of a union citizen, We need to understand this. This is the standard card. These cards are phasing away. A time will come that if you are using this card, you are going to have problems for reasons that I'm just about to explain. Because I have explained this over and over, but every week I'm still getting a lot of questions being thrown at me about the same stuff. So today I really want to spend a bit of time and do what and explain. And anyone that calls me during the course of the week, I will simply send this tape to them for them to listen. Because I'm doing the best that I can to break it down and make it as simple as I can. You know, and I believe that by the time we finish today's program, people will get a better understanding of how it works. So those people who have been issued with the card, if they've written on top residency card, then that means it has been issued under European law. Some of our brothers and sisters, they've also got their permanent residency or residency card some time ago, long time ago. And what they have is the vignette stamp, like the stamp that they put in their passport. And that stamp, normally you're going to have something like this, the characteristics of that stamp. I'm just about to explain it to you. Basically, it's a visa stamp which has been put in their passport, and these are the characteristics of those stamps. On there, once again, you will see that they will write your details on that stamp. And then they will then go on to say that you are an European Union national family member. Those people who had years long time ago, they will write their family member's name, the family member that you are a family member of. That means the European national that you derive those rights from. So they will write their names. So in any event, those people who have the vignette stamp in their passport and those people who have the residency card, as I've just explained, it is important that you also apply for settlement scheme visa. The difference is this. Those people that have the stamp, if you apply for the settlement scheme visa, you'll be issued with a biometric residency permit, European Union Settlement Scheme card. So you will see that they've written US, EUSS card. That means biometric residency permit card, which has been issued under the settlement scheme or the pre-settlement scheme. If you have settlement scheme, which is permanent residency, they will also write / indefinite leave to remain. That means it has been issued under British immigration law. If it is pre-settlement scheme, you will see that it will be written pre-settlement scheme / leave to remain. That means it has been issued under British law. If you have that type of card, you don't need to do anything. You are okay. You are sound. Also, those people who have acquired biometric residency permit card under the old law or under European law, if you apply for the settlement scheme visas, Home Office at the moment, their policy is that they will only issue you with a letter through an email to confirm your status. Home Office argument, or the UK government argument, is that you could assess your status online. And therefore, if you have a card that has been issued under European law, then there is no point in issuing another card under British law. This is the government argument. Of course, obviously, any decision that any rational human being will take will be influenced by economics. We are all economics. Any human being that is reasonable, that is sensible, will always apply economic principles in decision makings, especially when it comes to money, when it comes to cost, when it comes to its effect. So it is normal for the government to also make this argument on the basis that if you've already got a card, and the card, they've written on it, European Union residency card or residency permit, it makes no sense to give you another card that will have EU settlement status. That will be the only difference. And therefore, for the UK government, there is no point for those who already have a card to be given a new card. We also have to think about the environmental effect. Because if you keep producing cards, that means the old ones, even though it has not expired, you have to chop them up and throw them. The environmental consequences. So in some respects, I do understand where they are coming from. But this is the confusion that is going to create. There's going to be a lot of confusion. I am a lay person. I know nothing about law. Okay? As a layman, I know nothing about law. I am recruiting. I'm running a small business. And I want to recruit. Come 1st of January, we have come out of the European Union. As a layman, I have listened on the radio that we are not bound by European law. We are no longer, we don't have to follow European law. This is what I'm hearing from the radio. And I'm getting people to work for me. Mr. A applies, come for an interview, and I ask Mr. A, do you have the right to stay and work in the UK? Mr. A said, yes, I have the right to work in the UK. And then I asked Mr. A to show me his documentation that shows that he's got a right to work in the UK. Mr. A pull up his European Union residency card. And I can see from it, EU family member. As a lay person, I am reading into this like this. We have come out of the European Union. European Union law no longer applies in the UK. And now, this person is telling me he's got a right to work and he's showing me European Union card. It's very easy for a layman to come to conclusion that a card too is not valid because European law no longer applies in the UK. So that is the simplistic view that a lot of people could take. And therefore, an opportunity that has arisen for you and me can just disappear before our eyes. Or because someone must have misinterpreted the law. Someone may be ignorant of the law. And for that reason, a very good opportunity will go amiss. That aside, sometimes you have some, you know, you have immigration officers who do not even appreciate the law. They may be sitting at the airport. You go to, say, Babylon, and you are coming back to the UK. You get to the airport. Overzealous immigration officer, look at your card. Your card is written EU family member. As soon as he sees it, he starts thinking, hold on. You are a family member of an European national. We have come out of the European Union, and therefore Europe law no longer applies to us. So why should I accept this card? Even though in theory, you are okay because you have applied for the settlement scheme. You have your letter and the card. But the person could simply look at the letter and say, look, this letter could be fake. Or perhaps the letter does not match with the card. And therefore, I'm not going to allow you entry. These are some of the anticipated difficulties that people may face. And it takes, you know, a visionary lawyer like Lawyer Darko, Justice and Law Solicitors, to foresee these problems. Someone who is a seer, who is able to foresee future problems, anticipation, and then work towards that anticipation to free his people. You know, it doesn't take anyone to foresee this, but it takes, you know, special qualities for someone to be able to see these futures. Because for me, I link this to what has happened to the Windrush generation. And I keep saying this. We are all listening to me today. A time will come, an European national will be facing deportation. You'll be surprised. A time will come, someone who is a family member will be facing deportation because they did not take the steps that I'm about to tell you. You know, so it is important that we take these steps in order to avoid any foreseeable problems in the future. You know, Ghana Market, good morning to you. I greet you. And also Sergeant Amegazi, I greet you, madam, for tuning in. Mr. Solomon Ametefiu, thank you very much for tuning in. Let me take this opportunity before I continue the program to thank all these people for tuning in. And also Mr. James Redu, Mr. Bansa Birmingham, thank you for tuning in. Mr. Kweku Enin, also thank you for tuning in. Bright Desmond, Pastor Pat, wherever you are, good morning to you. Frank Kwame Owusu, Mr. Peche, good morning to you. Mama Boat, Bakope Lucy Adama Boat, good morning to you. Eric Edwin Jemfi, wherever you are, good morning to you. Okay, so let's start, let's continue on with the program. Abet Opoku, Na Onapo, 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 Onapo. I know that you'll be hearing from me soon. I've got a good feeling. Emmanuel Eshan, thank you for tuning in. Maria Sanda, good morning to you. Nandes Redu, thank you for tuning in. Bismarck Nana Kwame, also thank you for tuning in. Mr. Danny Yabua Jr., thank you for tuning in. Cynthia Ofe Adobuaku, also thank you for tuning in. Kukua AB, also thank you for tuning in. Let's continue with the program. As soon as you join us, you share the program. Okay, so now let's look at this. People may go into, you know, people are going to face problems. That one is without a doubt. So for me, it is important that you avoid those problems. So the government is saying that if you have a card, I'm not going to give you a new card until that card has expired. The problem is this. You show it to a layman, you show it to someone who doesn't know anything about the law, the person may not understand you. The government argument is that you could go online and access your right to work. That is fine. You come to a layman who doesn't know anything about a computer. You come to a busy man like myself who does not have time to switch on the computer to check. Do you think such people are going to be bothered? Especially if I'm recruiting and I have one vacancy and you have five people fighting for that vacancy. One of them will turn up with British residency card, and on it they've written indefinite leave to remain or leave to remain, and therefore, you know, it says what it is on the thing. Your one is a bit not straightforward. If I'm going to recruit and I don't have time to check with the Home Office, I will simply recruit the one that has got the visa that says what it is on the thing, rather than the one that I need to go and investigate to find out whether the person has got the right to work in the UK. So all that I'm saying to people is this: why it is not false, whilst it is not compulsory, that if you have applied and you have been issued with pre-settlement or settlement scheme visa, you also need to apply for a card to reflect your settlement status or pre-settlement status. I take the view that it makes sense. It is important in order to avoid humiliation, in order to avoid an opportunity, you know, disappearing from you. If I was you, I would take the necessary steps and move the next step. Even though I've been issued with settlement scheme visa or pre-settlement scheme visa, I will move on and apply for a pre-settlement scheme card or settlement scheme card so that it tallies with the email confirmation that I have received from the Home Office. So that when you show it to anyone, there is no question mark, there is no dispute, there is no halala, and there is no palava. You have it written as it is on the tin. It saves you from explaining yourself to a potential employer, to an immigration overzealous immigration officer, or it prevents you from going through the stress of being asked unnecessary questions. You know, so for me, I think it's relevant. It is important that even if you have applied for the residency pre-settlement scheme visa and settlement scheme visa, and it has been successful and you have been granted and you have been sent an email, I will suggest to you that you move on to the next step and apply for the GUSS card as well. Whilst it is not compulsory, for me, it is a recommendation. Apply for it. It stops a lot of, questions being asked, and it stops a lot of people questioning your right to be here and your right to work in the United Kingdom. So please do the best that you can. Spread the news, share it to people, let people know so that they can also benefit from this. Because a lot of people are going to go through tough times after we have come out of the European Union officially. So it is for this reason that Lawyer Darkon, courtesy of Justice and Law and Fire Life Radio, we keep, telling you, we keep banging on so that people will understand it, people will get a better understanding of what the policy is and apply for the card, to put their mind to rest. So that is all that I can say in relation to the residency card issue. Wow, did not realize that this has taken me this long. I need to take a sip of water. Let me play this tune, and as soon as we come back, we will continue the program. Right, before we go to the immigration update this week, there has been an interesting finding in terms of research carried out recently, and it was announced by the BBC during the course of the week. And I have sat down and I had a lot of thoughts about this and why this is the case. The research suggests that Africans in particular in this country, the children, when it comes to educational attainment, they perform better as compared to their white counterparts. So when it comes to GCSE, Africans do very, very well. But one reason or the other, after GCSEs, the attainment level start dropping. The question that are being asked is, why is that the case? In like any social issue, it's always very, very difficult to pinpoint that this is the case or that is the case. And many a times, it's a combination of different factors. But today, I will just make brief observation about something that we called symbolic interaction. When we say symbolic, it means symbols. What does symbol means? Labeling, what does it mean? Could it also have effect on the way our children behave, react after their GCSEs, the decisions that they make? Are they influenced by symbols? Are they influenced by what we say to them? Are they influenced by what society portrays? Are they influenced on our, own perceptions and also our prejudice and also the way we see the world around us. All these things, yes, of course, it can influence us in our decision makings and the things that we do. But this is something that I think as parents, we all need to watch out for and encourage our children. Because there's a theory. If you have time, you can search it up. It's called symbolic interaction theory. And symbolic interaction theory simply means what you anticipate, what you say, is what you work towards. So if for example, your child finished GCSE and you have nothing better, nothing good to say about your child, you are always being negative. Directly or indirectly, is going to have effect on the child. If you are telling your child you'll be up to no good, you are rubbish, you are no good, you don't know what you are doing, you'll be up to no good, you are a bad child. What are you telling the child? You are telling the child that he is a bad child and therefore he's going to do bad things. If you are telling your child will be up to nothing, then the child will make sure that he will be up to nothing. So words are powerful. We have to be very, very careful the way we choose our words. If someone trying to demonize your child, if someone is trying to tell you that your child it will be up to no good, as a parent, if you care, you fight for your child and you fight the person no matter what, because no adult has got a right to demonize any child. Any adult that does that is very wicked. Any adult that does that is very nasty. Any adult that does that is evil intent. Because people do that in order to demonize children, in order to destroy their future. If people do not realize this, when you are condemning a child, when you are trying to tell a child that a child is a bad child, when you are trying to tell a child that a child will be up to no good, whether you are trying to tell a child that a child is rude, whether you are trying to tell a child that a child is nasty, you are killing the child. You may not know this, but it has long-term effect on children. So it is for this reason that it is important as a parent. You must defend your child when your child is being demonized by devil and evil forces and demons. Because anyone that try to demonize a child, the person may not know, but if the person is doing it with bad intent, then that is evil, that is devilish, that is demonic. And therefore, as a parent, you must do whatever it takes to protect your child. Because once this negativity enters into a child's head, the child will begin to believe it. And once the child believes it, the child will react accordingly. So when it comes to the symbolic interaction theory, we called something called the notion of looking glass self. What you are told, what you portray, if you portray a child to be a good child, when the child looks in the mirror, it reflects. When the child looks in the mirror, the child will see a bad child. And as a bad child, I have to do what is expected of a bad child. So symbols interact. We interact with symbols. So what we are portrayed is what we lead up to, is what we do. We try to lead up to that expectation because we are being told that we are bad. We are being told that we are rebel. Because if you tell me that I'm a bad lawyer, don't expect good things from me. If you tell me I'm a good lawyer, it enforces me. It gives me power and also more energy to do the best that I can to be as good as I can to be a good lawyer for you. So it is important. Words are powerful, and we have to be very, very, very careful when it comes to the way we talk about children. Because for me, I will say this. People from minority, especially people from African origin, we say we do well at school up to O levels, and then from there we start falling. I strongly believe that is the way we interact with our children. We don't give them encouragement. We don't push them enough. And as a result, they begin to slack. Because you have a parent, both mom and dad are working full time. Because we all want to build our properties, and therefore sometimes we lose track of our children. They are teenagers at that age, going to A levels. We allow them to do whatever they want. The people that they mingle with, we don't even check. They tell us that they are going to the library. We don't even ask them when they went to the library how it went. And as a result, they get mingled with wrong crowd. And before you know it, the educational attainment and the target that we are expecting them to achieve drops significantly. And therefore, once it drops significantly, university level and also work level, it also drops. And therefore, we find ourselves in the condition that we find ourselves. Whilst there may be other factors that may affect our ability to get to a certain level, but you need to put yourself in a better position to achieve the best outcome of any condition that you find yourself. So that is what I will say in relation to symbolic interaction and also the effect of, you know, what people say and how we see ourselves and the educational system in that respect. However, there may be so many factors that may have contributed to that, but I have intentionally focused on symbolic interaction and how the way we portray ourselves, the way we see ourselves, and the way we see our children's future can also have impact in terms of their educational achievement or attainment. Okay, now let's look at court appeal. We move on to immigration area. The appeal judges, they have clashed over false documents in relation to birth certificate. This is a case that has gone before the Court of Appeal. And the case is called LLD against Secretary of State for the Home Department. And this is a case that a birth certificate was produced as evidence of someone's relationship with their parent, and it transpired the birth certificate was or appears to be fake. Home Office refused the application on the basis of false representation. The case went before the court, and this is a case in terms of fake documentation. The judges have had different opinions as to whether submitting a document that you don't even know that is false can amount to false representation. The courts in this case, they are split as to whether submitting a document that you don't think is fake documents can actually be deemed to be a false representation. And the judges could not even agree. So you can imagine, if you apply for birth certificate and it has been issued for you by an authority, and for whatever reason they turn out that they say that it's fake, can you be blamed for it? If you are in that situation, do not think that that is the end of it. Come to Justice and Law Solicitors, Lawyer Darko. We can do you justice. We can help you because we have some cases that we can use to fight your corner for you. So any documents that you have submitted that they have deemed to be fake, even judges could not agree. So in effect, that means you have still have a chance that we could go and apply for you, or we could go and fight your case for you. At the moment, if judges could not agree and it's a 50-50 case, that do not think, that does not mean that you could not apply as well. The second area is something called non-binary identity that can be used as a basis for an asylum. Let's look at this case. This case went before the upper tribunal, and the case is called The case is called, it's an interesting case, MX That's x ray, little x, mx. And this case is about gender identity. Gender identity. And in fact, I've learned something this morning when I was reading this case, because I did not know certain things, which, interestingly, I have got to know. Non-binary identity. And as the name will suggest, you know, when it comes to identity, in terms of gender or sex, we know that we have female and we have a male. So this is binary, is two, bi. But then again, we have the third option. These people are called non-binary identity. They don't conform to our traditional belief that when you are born, you are either male or female. They say that they are non-binary. So they are no male and they are no female. And the strange, well, it's not strange, but what I discovered this morning, which I was a bit surprised, is that their title, when they are using, maybe when people are using Mr. Mr. as their title, to be able to distinguish whether they are male or female, or they are using Miss, Miss, to signify whether they are female, or MX, to signify whether they are at a married age. Now, the non-binary people use MX, that's estuary. M for mother, X for estuary. That is what they are using. So I don't know how you pronounce this, whether it's Miss or what. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's something that we all have to learn. Because in this case, the person insisted that he is not referred to as a he, Mr. Mr., and he must not be referred to as Mrs., MRS, or MS, or MISS. Instead, he should be referred to by a title, MX. So this is not about law. This is something that we all have to learn. Because some people, if you refer to them as MR, they will not be happy with you. If you refer to them as MISS, they will not be happy with you. If you refer to them as MS, which is for MS, M for mother, S for sugar, they will not be happy with you. In fact, they may take an offense to that. So we all have to learn this. The world that we live in is revolving. The world that we live in is changing every time. So it is important, if the person tells you that he is or she is non-binary, then you have to respect their choice and refer to them as MX. It is very, very, very important. Because if you don't, it's simply going to lead to a complaint. So if you are working anywhere, you've got to be aware of these developments, these social changes that are occurring around us. Because I did not know this until today. And I was very, very shocked. I've never seen it before. I was very, very surprised by it. So if someone describes himself as non-binary, i.e. he's not a man, he's not a woman, but he's the third option or the third way, it is important that you do what? That you understand that the person title is MX. M for mother, X for estuary, and you learn something from this. So this is a case that this man here, in his hometown of El Salvador, he claims that he was being abused because he is a gay person, i.e. homosexual. Yeah, homosexual. So he was facing degrading and inhumane treatment in his home country of El Salvador. And as a result, he applied for an asylum in the United Kingdom. What he said was that in his hometown, people were pouring urine as well as rubbish on him for practicing homosexuality. He applied for asylum in the UK. The asylum was refused because the judges felt that the treatment that he was facing was not serious enough to merit an asylum being issued. And therefore, the asylum was refused. He then went back and made an application on the basis that he is now non-binary. He is no man, he's not a woman. And on that basis, the Secretary of State for the Home Department, which is the Home Office, must look into his case again. The Home Office refused the application on the basis that being non-binary does not put you within the definition of an asylum, i.e., you are not fearing persecution on grounds of race, nationality, religion, social group, and nationality and religious opinion, political opinion, and so on and so forth. So the application was refused. This man said no. So he appealed to the upper tribunal. And upper tribunal this week had made a decision that if someone make an application on the basis of being non-binary, well, it falls within the definition of a refugee. And therefore, the Home Office must look into it. So all that I say is this. If you feel that you are non-binary, you don't conform to the male and the female stereotype created by society, then of course you can also do what? Claim an asylum on that basis. Now let's look at the 7 years concessionary policy and the rules. I'm very sure that we are all familiar with this. We know that if you are living here and you are under the age of 18 and you've been living in the UK for continuously for 7 years, either born in the UK or you have been in the UK for 7 years, you can apply for leave to remain under Appendix FM of the immigration rules. There is nothing wrong with that. Yes, you can make an application. But the catch of this application is that you need to prove that it will be unreasonable for the Secretary of State to deport you back to your home country or expect you to leave the United Kingdom. This is what it is. So it is important that we do understand this. It's not because your child is 7 years and therefore automatically you should be granted. No, that is not the case. You need to be able to prove that it will be unreasonable. And what are the factors that they may take into an account when making these decisions? Let's look at number one. I have listed about 7 factors here that the Home Office will take into an account. So if you are making an application on the basis of 7 years or on the basis that your child is 7 years, it is crucial that you understand this. It is crucial that you understand these factors. You need to be able to tick the boxes within these factors in order to make a successful application. Firstly, you need to prove or you need to be able to convince the Secretary of State that there will be a significant risk to your health or to the child's health. For example, if they are undergoing a treatment for a serious illness or life-threatening disease in the UK, and that treatment is not available in their home country. You see, sometimes, you know, I remember doing a similar case about 9 years ago. And this girl suffered from, what is that disease? That disease is very, very common among black people. I can't remember the name now. Sickle cell, you know. They went to different lawyers and they said that, sickle cell is common and therefore, if you do the application on the basis of sickle cell in 7 years, the application would not be successful. Because the mistake that they made was that they assumed that sickle cell, they are all the same. But in fact, they have different levels of sickle cell. When the person came to justice and law, we were able to communicate with the lawyers, with their doctors, and get a better understanding of that medical condition. And on that basis, we were able to do what? We were able to make a successful application because we were able to liaise with the doctors. They were able to explain the type of sickle cells and the effect, the impact on this child and the parents. And on that basis, we were able to secure the child as well as the parents on the basis of 7 years residency in the UK, as well as the child suffering from a sickle cell. So I always say this, each case is similar, but they can never be the same. So in this case, we were successful in making an application. So when you have a client and a client have certain types of illness or conditions, do not assume that they are all the same, because each illness, each condition is, you know, different from the other. So in this case, even though it's a sickle cell, that some lawyers were of the opinion that it was a common illness, it can be treated in Ghana, blah, 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 blah. But after getting in touch with the doctors, they were able to break it down, the types of sickle cell, the conditions, and the crisis that this particular person was facing, and how difficult it would be for this person to be able to reintegrate, to be able to get the, you know, the facilities and the support that is needed for this person to be able to function. And therefore, the doctors in this particular case concluded that even though there may be facilities in Ghana, but it is not as high quality as it is in the UK. And therefore, the services and the quality that the child has experienced in the UK, they may not be able to give the person the same care in Ghana. And for that reason, it would be unreasonable to expect the child to be able to relocate to Ghana. So it is very, very important that we do what? We do the best that we can, and each case is treated differently. You cannot put all eggs in one basket. Even twins coming from the same womb at the same time, they can never be the same. So it is important that you distinguish, you separate the eggs from the chaffs. So it's very, very important that we do that. So if the child is got medical condition, it is important as lawyers, as advisors, we investigate it thoroughly and see its effect on the child. And also, if the child is forced to go back home, what is going to happen to them? So it is important. Point two, if the child has wider family ties in the United Kingdom, this is something that a lot of people take for granted. If the child has got family members, cousins, aunties, uncles, and they all have papers, they all have papers to stay in the UK, and he has formed family life with them, they've got strong bonds and connections with them, then of course we need to get all these people to write supporting letters, any correspondence, any affiliations, any links that he's got with the United Kingdom. You need to spread it out. So for example, you know, if he's got a cousin that he believe visit them every week, the fact that you visit each other, the fact that you have integrated as a family, the fact that you have uncles, the fact that you have other family members, friends, of course, it is important that all this is listed in the representation. Other factors may include whether the child has visited or lived in another country. So if, for example, the child has been here for 7 years, born here for 7 years, the child has never visited your home country, then of course it will be very, very difficult for the child just to be dumped at one place just like that. It's not going to work. This is an argument that can also be put forward. Also, whether the child has got any cultural ties to that country, if the child knows nothing about the country, then culturally it will be very difficult for the child to be able to go there and assimilate. So that can be used as well. Also, whether the child can speak the language, write the language, and read the language. Also, if that is not the case, you can bring that in, that if you take my child back, you know, the child is going to struggle because he doesn't speak the language, he doesn't write the language, and he doesn't read the language. How is he going to fit in there? And it's very funny that when it comes to Ghana and you are making this type of applications, if Home Office are refusing, they say that, oh, Ghana is an English-speaking country and therefore the child can reintegrate easily. But if you are an advisor, this is a free advice, you need to put it in that Ghana is not on the list of acceptable English-speaking countries. And therefore, that argument that Ghana is an English-speaking country cannot be used, cannot be relied on by the Home Office. As simple as that. Because Home Office cannot choose and select and pick whenever they want. Because when it comes to naturalization and it comes to application for leave to remain, further leave to remain, Home Office tell us that if you are from Ghana, as an example, you still have to do the test. you still have to take the test. But when it comes to things like this, all of a sudden, they turn around and say that Ghana is an English-speaking country. So if Ghana is an English-speaking country, then of course, if you're applying for a spousal visa, then the Home Office will not expect you or should not expect you, must not expect you, arguably, to provide an English test certificate. Because according to them, when it suits them, they say Ghana is an English-speaking country. So for me, before they say that, I think you need to attack before they use that to attack you. So this goes for the representatives. Also, you need to look at the Charles, his future plans, what he intends to do. You know, so there are so many factors, but to name a few that you can bring it into play when it comes to 7 years concessionary policy. First representation, it is important that we understand this. If you submit any application to the Home Office which is false or which Home Office deemed to be incorrect, then, of course, they can refuse the application on the basis of paragraph 322, false representation of the immigration rules. But let's look at what the Home Office says. The Home Office guidelines says as follows: considering false representation, if false information is provided as part of an application, either orally or in writing, including deliberately withholding relevant information or submitting false documents, Home Office must consider refusing application for entry clearance or leave to remain on eligibility grounds, and if there is evidence of dishonest or deception on grounds of false representation. The guidelines to caseworkers goes on to read that it is important to be clear in the decision whether false representation was made in relation to the current or a previous application, and by whom it was made, as that will determine what action should be taken. Burden and standard of proof is on the balance of probability. And that the Home Office goes on to say that before they conclude, in some cases, they need to give the person a warning before they make a decision. But what I've come across is that most of these cases, Home Office do not give a warning. They simply go on and repeat and basically refuse the application on the basis of false representation. But if you look at the Home Office guidelines properly, it's very, very important. If you are fighting false representation, the guideline says the allegation of dishonesty or deception, because what they say is that in order to come to conclusion that someone has made false representation, there have to be an allegation of dishonesty or deception, and it must be serious. You know, so if someone, for example, make a mistake, this is the key. Mistake is an excuse in law. Mistake is an excuse in law. The document was not submitted deliberately. There are some factors and there are some ways in which you can fight some of these cases. So once again, if you have been bombarded with or your application has been refused on the basis of false representation, come and see Lawyer Darko David, Justice and Law Solicitors, and we'll do the best that we can to help you. Once again, I'm very, very tired. Let me take a bit of a break, 5 minutes break, and then when I come back, I will talk about the consumer rights, and we will speak to a special guest, Pastor Lawrence. Today, we will also be speaking to Mr. Eshan Amways, and we will also be speaking to Paradise City briefly. So we have three people that we'll be speaking to, and bear with us, because I know that what they are going to say, apart from bringing you the legal matters and advising you about the law, they also have something for you which may benefit some of our listeners. So let's take this quick break, and then when we come back, we will continue the program whilst I take a bit of water to drink, courtesy of Amway, Mr. Eshan. Thank you. Yes, a quentia, a ye musuo, sika, and ye o drew a woo a drew. What say? Sika, and ye o woo a drew. Anna, and quentia, a ye musuo. We ye a codaso soa, siantie, and sana, what siya mbrike too. Sana etie. Consumer law. What are your consumer rights? We are all going into Christmas. Today is the last Saturday of November. December is starting next week, and as consumers, as human beings, we buy and sell product, goods and services. We are going into Christmas, and it is important that we understand as consumers what are our rights, because so much is going to happen between now and 1st of January in terms of consuming law or consumer law. So it is important that I kind of bring you some advice, some hints and tips in relation to your rights and what you can do. Just in case you buy a product that is faulty, product that is not fit for purpose. Once we understand this, then I think we'll be able to make the most out of it. Sometimes it's not, you know, whether you are right or wrong, but it's about how you put your case. It is very, very important. And one thing that I have learned about life and about this country, regardless of who you are, regardless of how rich you think you are, this country, when you look at the difference between the rich and the poor, the gap, the wealth gap, it's like this. It's not that big. You can be a millionaire and drive a Tesla. I can be poor and drive a scooter. Nobody give a hoot about anybody. But countries like Ghana, when you are living there and you are driving a Tesla, people bow down before you because of poverty. People sell their rights as adults because of poverty. People sell their grace because of poverty. People sell their pride because of poverty. But in this country, what the rich man can do, the poor man can do. And as a result, this country, you go with respect, but not for what you have. You go with dignity and class for not what you have. This country, you can have every money on this earth, but nobody cares about it. It's all about dignity, style, connection, and also respect. So it is very, very important how you speak, how you make people respect you, how you conduct yourself. Because this country, you cannot buy anyone. It's as simple as that. This country, people are not starving, and therefore you cannot buy their dignity. You cannot buy people in this country. You cannot buy their support. You cannot buy their affection. Because what you can buy, they can also buy something similar, if not the same. So this country is about knowing your rights and what to say when it comes to consuming law, when it comes to consumer law. In Ghana, if you are rich, if you are powerful, if you are in a position, you get your way. But this country, the system works, the law works, as compared to maybe where we come from. Because of poverty, people are prepared to sell anything, including their pride. But in this country, nobody will sell their pride to anybody, regardless of what. So it is important that we understand the law. Because while the law is there, you must follow the law. The poor, the rich, you are all following the same law. So it's important that as consumers, it does not discriminate between the rich and the poor. There is a bit of equality before the law in this country as compared to countries like Ghana. And I think it's important that we need to understand that when we are trading, when we are purchasing goods and services, when we want to return them, we want to refund them, we need to know what to say. We need to know what the law says are the lawful excuses. So let's go through it. If you are buying a digital content, especially, say you are buying music online, it's very, very important. You are buying music online, and for some reason, you are downloading the content, it's not working, and so on and so forth. What does the law say? Because Christmas is coming, and I'm pretty convinced that some of us may be buying maybe, you know, films online to watch with their family. So you buy it and you cannot watch it because it's not working. What are your rights as a consumer? The Consumer Contract Regulations of 2013 says as follows. You have a 14-day right to change your mind and get a full refund on your digital content. You do not have this right to cancel once a download has started, provided you have been told this and have acknowledged this. So the first thing is this. If you are buying any digital content, you have 14 days to change your mind, provided that you have been told that once you start downloading it, then the 14-day refund will not be applicable. You cannot change your mind. Because once you start downloading it and it's downloading, you cannot then go back to say that I don't want it, because you have already downloaded it. And therefore, you have already got the product. So you cannot then go back and say that I don't want it. Now, let's look at the Consumer Rights Act of 2015, what it says about digital content. And what it says is this, that the digital content must be as described and must be fit for purpose and of satisfactory quality. So if you buy it and it's not of a good quality, that is a reasonable excuse to go for refund. It's very, very important. It must be fit for purpose. That is very, very important. And it must fit the description. So you cannot simply just say that I don't want it. But if you don't want it, it must come with qualification. One, it must be as it is described. So if, for example, you are buying a video or you are buying a film online and they've told you that, on the description, they have said that, it's a family oriented film, and therefore all family members, it's not classified, all family members can watch it. You download it, you are watching it, and you see pornographic material. As soon as you see that, it's very, very clear that the description and what you are seeing, they are totally two different things. And therefore, you can go back for your money, for a refund. This is sometimes some of the things that black people or Africans, we don't do. Because I have seen people arguing and getting their money back in this type of scenario. So it is important that we understand the basis in which you can go for a refund. It's very, very important. If your digital content is faulty, you are entitled to repair or a replacement. If you buy a digital content and it is faulty, you are entitled for them to repair it or a replacement. It's very, very important. We need to watch out for that. If the fault cannot be fixed, or if it hasn't been fixed within a reasonable time and without significant inconvenience, you can get some or all of your money back. That is what the law says. So it's not a matter of I don't want it, I want my money back. It will depend on the circumstances of each case and each person. So it is very, very important. Thirdly, if you can show that the fault has damaged your device and the seller have not used reasonable care and skill, you may also be entitled for the repair of your device as well as a compensation. That is digital content. What about goods that you have purchased in a shop? Christmas comes, a lot of people go to the shop to shop. So it is important that we understand the principles as well. The Consumer Rights Act of 2015 says that goods must be as described. It must be fit for purpose and of satisfactory quality. During the expectation lifespan of the product, you are entitled to the following. If your goods are faulty, you can get an immediate refund up to 30 days. If it cannot be repaired or replaced, then you are entitled to a full refund in most cases, and this is up to 6 months. If the goods do not last a reasonable length of time, you may be entitled to some money back. This is up to 6 years. So basically, if the good is faulty and basically is causing you inconveniences, within 6 years, you may be able to return it and get some of your money back. So it is important that when you buy stuff from the shop, sometimes you see that they will give you a warranty. You need to check the warranty as well. But Consumer Rights Act tells us, or the Consumer Contract Regulations tells us, you know, that in some cases, you should be able to return it back. But then again, it all depends on what you bought, when you bought it, and how long you have used it for, and what the problem is. So it is important that we use this as a guide when we are shopping or when something goes wrong. Goods ordered at home. So you are sitting in your house, you order the goods. According to the Consumer Contract Regulations 2013, it says as follows. After receiving your goods in your house, in most cases, you can change your mind and get a full refund if it is done within 14 days. The Consumer Rights Act of 2015 says goods must be as described, fit for purpose, and of satisfactory quality. During the expected lifespan of your product, you are entitled to the following. Let's look at this. If your goods are faulty, you can get a full refund if it is sent back within 30 days. If it cannot be repaired or replaced, then you are entitled to a full refund in most cases within 6 months. If the goods do not last a reasonable length of time, you may be entitled to some money back within 6 years. that is goods ordered at home. But then again, it will depend whether it's a perishable goods or not. But that is a general guidelines. What about services paid for in a shop? The Consumer Rights Act says the following. You can ask the service provider to repeat or fix a service if it is not carried out with reasonable care and skill, or get some money back if they cannot fix it. Two, if you have not been able to agree a price beforehand, what you are asked to pay must be reasonable. And thirdly, if you haven't agreed a time scale beforehand, it must be carried out within a reasonable time. So fixing it must be done within a reasonable time. What is reasonable, once again, will depend on the circumstances. Services ordered at home. The Consumer Contract Regulations 2013 says the following. In most cases, you can cancel within 14 days. If you agree the service will start within this time, you may be charged for what you have used. That is services ordered at home. If you have used some, then you'll be paying for what you have used. According to the Consumer Rights Act of 2015, you can ask the service provider to fix the problem. And if it's not carried out within a reasonable time, with care and skill, you get some money back if they cannot fix it. If a price hasn't been agreed upfront, what you are asked to pay must be reasonable. And if time hasn't been agreed upfront, it must be carried out within a reasonable time. So this is just a summary, a breakdown of what I have to bring you today. Christmas is coming up. This is the consumer law, and this is your guide. Don't call me and say, lawyer, what about this, what about that? You can always go back and play the video, and it will give you the guidelines for you to be able to use it as well. Today, I am very happy and I'm very glad. We will do the best. We're going to speak to this man of God. He's been very, very influential. And I will also thank him for giving me opportunities all those years. You know, gone are the days that, you know, we were, you know, asking to go to show, to go to, you know, places, even to give free legal advice, and we were being turned down. But this man of God gave us a platform. He gave us a place. And for that reason, today we're going to have a short word with him, and then we can speak to Mr. Ishan and Paradise City, and then we can then activate the telephone lines. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for staying in. Mr. Abiam, good morning to you. Mr. Rushin Educhung, thank you very much for joining us and good morning to you. Mr. Ishen Ababekayensa, Mr. Ishen, Amway product. Last week, a lot of people were asking me, you know, the details were given to them. Today, as you can see on the screen at the comment section, by all means, we have posted something there that you can also have a look as well. Amway product, this man has been a wonderful and it's been a blessing to me and my family. You all have to thank him for me. You know, life is worth knowing people. Life is worth building bridges. Because if you build a bridge, you never know when the person will also be building a bridge for you. No man is an island. When you come across any human being, show decency, show respect to that person. And I don't know what to say. I salute you, sir. And thank you for joining us. My family and I will forever be grateful to you for the wonderful things that you have also done in our lives. You know, when it comes to blessing, sometimes people look up the sky and expecting some blessing from the skies. But God uses man to bless others. And for me, I am blessed and I've been a blessing. So many people have, you know, contributed directly, indirectly to my life journey. And I will forever be grateful to all those people. Anyone who has been in my life, negatively, positively, for me, any negativity, I still draw strength from it. And there are so many ways that you can be blessed. Even if someone is cursing you, don't see that as negative. See that as positive. Because you can always make positive out of negative. And for me, this man has been a positive influence in my life. So I welcome you, Mr. Emmanuel Eshen, Amway product. People watch me and they say, lawyer, you are getting younger every day. What is the secret? Mr. Amway is here today. He's going to answer that for you. Because I don't know what to say. Over the years, he's given me a lot of Amway product for free because of an impact that I was able to make in his life. Last week or 2 weeks ago, he called the program and he also shared a bit of testimony. How he came across, how he discovered me, how he came to me, and basically what I, through God, what I was able to do for him and his family. You see, life, sometimes you can find someone at his vulnerable state. Do not take advantage of people's vulnerability. Do not step on another human being. Because the very people that you meet when you are going up are the very people that you will meet when you are going down. Don't let situation, because of your situation today, gets into your head to look down upon another man. There is a saying that the only time that you look down upon another man is when you are admiring their shoes. And I am pleased to welcome this man of God as well to join us today. I've known this man for over 10 years. And before I introduce him, before he talks, I want to say that I thank God for his life and I thank God for his family life. Because for me, he has made a very good impact in my life. He has contributed to who I am today. And anyone who has succeeded one way or the other through Justice and Law Solicitors, Fire Life Radio, and Lawyer Darko. This man here, Mr. Lawrence Enim, is one of those unsung heroes. Behind the closed doors, through prayers, through opportunities, even though I haven't opened my mouth to say this to him direct, but today I'm saying to him that I thank him for all those years, for his support, and for the opportunities that he has put in my way. May the anointing of God be upon him and his family. And may the Lord Almighty God bless him eternally. And I believe that all those people saying, Ladaku, may God bless you. Indirectly, you are also blessing him. Because he has contributed enormously to my life journey. And especially when it comes to the provision and the provision of services of immigration advice to the diasporians in the UK. Pastor Lawrence, good morning to you.
Oh, good morning, Lawyer Backhold. Oh, good morning.
Good morning,
I'm humble. I'm humble. I'm surprised.
Aye, also for sana area seno etie na area seno de yam kasa asim we se obi e bibi mawa e bibi fo meka ne sase me sa kan biem me mfa tuo enkosi ni tirim so se damase ne ne echine ya because unim dachin bi ba bia ko na ase e be free aba enti me de I'm very very humble and it's good to get to know you. And also I do remember 10 years ago when I started Justice and Law. I did approach some pastors. I wanted to come to their churches and give free advice. They turned me down. They said, no, they don't want to know.
Wow.
But when I contacted you without hesitation, one thing that you said I would never forget. We say, I have your fear. Anytime my PBI will come. And through you and through Justice and Law, I'm sorry, ma. Namia Dumunti Omunya Omon Krata Emma Omo Asum Ajo Womo.
Okay.
Nanya Susum Womo. Baby, I'm a call ya or catch him say no way no. 2 years' time, I feel anybody chasing me because we hear immigration advice.
Wow.
And a we are saying, you see, the rejected stone
shall God.
Always be the cornerstone.
Hallelujah.
And next, so who will be the former? Men slimy pano, minty adeso. Help the person to rise rather than say ube jubilate on someone's downfall.
Yes.
Because if we are saying you never know. And you are saying the humpa. And you are suffering. And ne, Mr. Sono, I want to return the favor.
Oh my God.
Medawasipi, nami inshallah. Na ene, Ediana, womaye, Pastor Eni.
No cry, and then we will be ma Wabusia and me or my Nan Sana Mekosono, Wakasem Bia Viniano, Nami Messi, when Jesus Ubiti, Lawyer Darko, no being justice and lawyer. Obi any one, I recommend the Naman Lawyer Darko, said you, Yammy and Sinidi and William. Madame Fubia and Nibako, my in Abishia, dear together, Nana Brabo, I say. Or friendly telephones with me to Kako, if you were Kent. So near blue which you need. Oh, I don't fool be not lawyer for Catherine is in the year. Beginning young couple in the show was a quadrillion near man of a bread lawyer back. Now, or can be said that some hinds a hand behind the oil. Meaning Sasa and Sano. And on a demo when you young, Nippon are recommending no more. Who went in was with us. And if we don't pay a chair of fire life radio for a bush and four. And then my baby drew Montana, beginning a meeting moon, a detriment ye be at the Atremo, and Yanko Ponte, a jubilee to Macumasua. Ye ye non so be a boa, ye community. Say, ye na ye boa boy. Now, lawyer be some son of pay, dear me, dear me, one of pay no any say. yewo delivery services a yede boa enuanom se wotie ofie na opese odidi wo ye restaurant owner na opese oton wadu ane na oba ye platform no so ye creative platform bi a ye frɛ no ipa or ye chrome ntɛ meka se ye pa fresh food app na sa app wo ye benya no play store ana sa app store wonya app no as a customer ye customer for there de twa duane ne ye driver for there so opadwuma ye wadwuma sɛ na kakra bi a wo bi twa wo ho edunti ne ye kasa wa ha no wo download a driver for app na wo benya information no ho ena sɛ wo pe bibi di wa kwadwuma kwaye adwuma wo ntimi no aduane na wo mpɛ sɛ wo bedi the chicken and chips no nko a na wo bedi ye kurom nuane ne bia titiru pa ye kurom restaurant for no ena ye normal chef ya omo wo platform no so ntimi ton safre wo bia wo ha sɛ ɔmfa ne ho mɛbɔ saa dwumadie na nea wopɛ sɛ wodi biara no mmerɛ a wote wo fie no anuanom bi nso de bɛbrɛ wo na yɛn nso yɛaboaboa yɛ ho nti lawyer fire radio ɛna nɔpɛi deɛ yɛwɔ a yɛde berɛ da ne di akyerɛ abusuafo lawyer ana maka ho asɛm no nti sɛ kwasin bi wɔ hɔ a wada worɔ mu
a yɛda wɔ se na spelling no sanka wotumi spelling ma yɛ a because as a I pa as a pa entino so get me spelling my ear said you be call na say o input as a application store ni mu and na say play store ni ma na what me anya the correct spelling and na o di shame so a symbol be na baso because sometimes in education no e bi mu de en shada nko yi papa ento bi o ha otimi identify picture with something rather than a din no and you know, once I body now, so many different things will come up. Abia modi no application a yellow, and I say entoma, and I say what? How does it look like? Ebe boye pa. In two cases no, me bo edia share comment section hono mo. Now ubi biara opese oye di. Uti mi a download you application, you know. Uti mi a download you. There also for can a very simple, and a very good idea. O say ya oma ye ye friend is saying application biya. Uye gane ni ba, sebio, uye bema na odo yeri ya, enye debia na beka se, onko che mukase, enwe duyane, enono, eye nkurase fuwa wari ye sebio, madode sumi naso, yeti ya brochili, enye debia na, ubo kachwa yeri sonko tina kitchen, enwe duyane, edi ya warijaye neba, epiwe bia, appreciate your wife, na onku se, ono so so sombo, ene ose, oh darling, ene me nwe duyane, eme ode duyane ya ba, na ye di, na ye so ya ye fine, e fe kwa, e chese u appreciate ni pa mo, oka se obi se onko onfa na yire kranko restaurant no onko spend the £20 or say me body e to 10 bags of cement 10 bags of cement you know one say ya obi we na wooden sibo enti no ye mo modern na ye nye ye life no ye change ne kakra so na ye ma spice e ma our life no se bi o se bi onye de bia na ebetinya tenase anu aduane anu aduane anu aduane se ubu yire ana se we appreciate na sometimes you know you also have to do these things. Until me feel say a very good idea. Sebio, ya da kunkuku asi kurasini. At least me wants application away. Meet me. Enye diyan meka che me rese onu eduane. Me ba fear. Enon say, oh darling, don't worry. Me diyan be ba fear. Na ma bo pa. Na ma order. Me dru fear. Na bibia ye so chi. Ye wea. Ye diya fe how far. Enti no. Application. Efe ne aipa. Ana se aipa. Application. Ah, osofo. Sankade spelling ni mamia. Na ma bo ashe hon. Mnu bie mse
bie fiti. Bacho yo lawyer na mse wo profo no e wo anu mbebre nti na oka na aifa no na nti idea no se e twi ne dia ba profo
okay
e twi na ye mpese ye be no eye ye twi dia beka se eye pa e y e b a na a profo fo no mo he spelling dia beka se aifa ye ji ni nyina tu e y e p a no ama space no abo fresh. So you didn't get any air fresh and go straight away. Air fresh. EYEPA. Now the food that can
fresh.
Hyper fresh food.
And the fresh food in India. A boom.
Food that you mum air so when you bought hyper fresh. App no be Yaman or other Play Store or App Store, but only food can one is all your customer. Open so to be an
air. Oh, okay.
And now the driver can one now, yeah. Obi a opesa o drive one aso opedwuma and how the store ka ho an is all your restaurant owner.
Oh, okay.
But the moment I obeka EYEPA no we just space na the fresh asimu no ya ka na ebeba.
Okay.
ade aka ne beba na wo kan se e ti se eye tuntum
mhm
na ni tuntum ye mu no aye se ho bibi ti se aye se enwa
snail
enwa symbol bi ti se enwa symbol ene da so
okay
na enya nwa me di epo mu na e kire mu se eye happy face obi a nani age
oh happy face e, okay
aha nti aduane de o ze aduane ma obi a ni che
sa
nti ye de ni gie na ebre nkrofo fi but wo fe symbol na aye se nwa bi sa
okay
but eye ni gie e na eye pa fresh food ye de ba ifi ni ankwa ankwa wo ye juma wo ni yire nya nware ye ye be bo a ma wa brabo aye boko
ah ene osofo ye da wase pi na obi kan ye ye se de ofudua pa no ana ye pia no ye nyina ye mfa yakoma eni sa application ye chi o download a me mfa nhye wo fedi konkon sa chiri wunu ye bi na ye su ye ntimi promote our own because emre pi no aya na wo ye ade mpa na wunu ye bi pese o twon ba wachi sa spirit no eye the spirit of the evil se yesi yesu nyame na se ye jinyame di a ye nchenji abrabo se obi de ye yi a ana wo so de ye yi e bia enipa na nyame abon na wa ma na develop application we you know la yada committee we se mesme boa no na se ekoso a e bia daachi bi otwa nani a o se la yada kom beji wan bo bi na wo susu fedi ebi promotion bi e ma no no e na ma me wan bo no ka me twi ni san aka nya wan bo no aka me nya wan bo no enti ina ye mo ye ho boden na e ye pa ye ko download application no na se pese o da aduane a ye timi ajusu application no se de as we ban fa so ama ye eni ye busia because enye de bia ana e beka se oba no aduane ana se enye de bia na bema obetimi ano aduane edrum re bia e wose otimi to aduane ana enye sika bia na yedi ana enye sika bia na betimi a save edu ba bia ese wo spendi enti na yebe shrepi yemfa ento yadwinim se eye pa fresh eno na abaso eye pa food eno na yebe die se ye pa adwuma mpo a eye pa delivery se ye pa adwuma mpo a ebi da hɔ no enti enuanom soso a omo adwuma sɛi won se we soso a create opportunity ama ye ho ye ho ye ho enti se ye spend this car within our community a ebeboa ama yeso ye tumpon jewfo omo spend this car within their community pa enti tembia no omo okosoro yeso ye nsua bi na ye ntimi empromote ye ho ye ho na ebeboa ye nyina menim se amonfo be wo questions at some point but at the moment ne de e me se wo question bi a no betimi a type aba be go Facebook comment section no so wo question bi asoso a obetimi afre echire na me sure say me pe osofo number na me de ba betudwa enti wo question bi obetimi afre no na otimi answer amao enti for the time being ni de e me say ye de osofo besia Pastor Lawrence na me de bi kan si kai ye no obi e me papa lo ya da ko mi wure mfi da me I don't forget things e bia eno na e me weakness because me udi mboni a me wure mfi o wo ye papa so me wure mfi. This is me. And I'm a bit dimboni. I always pray saying I'm coping on and mammy and hoddy and make me the boniache. Cause who dimboni and me do be. At the moment, and I say, my, to me, bong on pie passing and coping on mammy and coma, Naminia coma forgiveness. Because if you're dimboni, be a minana, me for one channel. You know, which is a bad thing. But I don't know. But me bong on pie saying, I'm a mammy, sa strength, no, the strength of forgiveness. Because if you're dimboni, be a minana, me spare no, me dinibi. You know, and I have the feeling so we didn't bother me. I mean, didn't we? Hey, Bia, that's not the right approach. And to make us a we also for idea. Now, so the empire, but Abuami, it was a direction. No, if you are still obeying him in the weakness, may that is my weakness.
Yo,
it was off. Yeah, that's a power.
Lawyer meant to be the Yanko Ponda was it. Mr. Wassi was out when you were in Yanko Pon Shrau. Now, all my favor when you made it to Abraham and Nashifono. Indeed, what you mean him. Ndi wetumechi seni unyankopon diwa bedruno onfa unto asusa
amen
so i document mpoko tu bebi na si nipe niwa unyame abofo unyina ho na oni nipa no nkasa on behalf of your client on behalf of the people that depend upon you, people whose hope are gone. Amen. Also for a lawyer.
Amen.
From
us off from a jack and home. Yes, yeah, my watch me now. Yeah, my hinny away near our chammy or crab ball.
Yes,
I said the CP.
Yo, bye bye.
Bye bye for now. Okay. Eda also for us. Young court, Mr. Ishanho, na yeninin komoka krebina afe a most amount for frepa, but munyan to was here my baby line, not to my Miss Mupi. Young court, Mr. Ishanho, na on so yeninin chin komoka krebi, near the paradise city, a chin komona fee be a matro for nothing.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Eshan.
Hello, lawyer.
MC Batuan Common is so. MC Bapandi, also for the full film, be real, you know. Young person, I am to us. Yes.
It has to be brave while Quinja with a man in there. To send a work canoe, Minimia, a boy was some numboya with our boy family. The yard games, you be free that. I be I atro. Na what can you know say? Can Bible no? Na for two quarter gym. I do a dog wagging, which means that a good piano, which means no can Bible no, not just a watch. I say, Sana or fence and your wire man, and yaddy will be free. And I be now, you can say, your wire man and your cassia, that the washes will be brave. One boy out with our family, and we'll go so I will be wine, and me show. Last week I'm saying about never be so about your product in on the end, but what can say be our yeah trying to be a yeah summarizing maybe way naya way naya way naya. And as a result, I started some year comparison. Now, offense, I started with diabetes and say product in the end. I call I acquire him. I am a person who is a protein a womb, a muffin double X. They were all plant protein neutralized. Double X near 85 pounds 95. In all plant protein neutralized, and so yeah, 34 pounds 70. Near omega 3 complex neutralized, and so yeah, 40 pounds 80. Near our calmag D, which is calcium magnesium D plus. Neutralized, you see a 34 pounds 70. Neo biting C plus, this 19 pounds 55. Neo Bibri, no a boy we need in on a nazi. Now biting C plus, no so by vitamin C nadi womb, and also it me pushy. Yes, system no ma it may a boy am I it me diabetes you a kufum. Neo mineral sticks, you see a 22 pounds 60. Now, your iron folic plus, and also a boom or bujani D circulation, and I say a bujani D in firm wall when I'm the animal. Also a 13.35. Now, your vitamin C plus and kasa and kasa. Now, only to me, he pollution, which me, he pains, which me, also ma, or blood sugar, and a kufum. Your magnesium sticks. X Richard, Mrs. Anna, Mrs. Etty, but on that is a offense and drink. I will reach me animal straight away. And also, I bought my offense and I say blood sugar, aquaform. Now, we didn't have a 334 pounds 20 into a pack. It is a water, also water pack me now. Wouldn't to be my wind jibby. I have sometimes maybe so me talk with me now. Which me are boomer and I say in a day a pack. Until only be to me up one to take by 2-3 months time. Who pursue ye for what ya up to 3 to 6 months? No, on no bit me ye for a quas with the insulin so and also would that offense and tablet as well on no be we for a cry and not just a wash or two out in this sanity. But you will start this a woman in a coffin where diabetes and blood and sugar, a belly, a coffin, maybe a higher fine. Number can give you another one, and so you are both for a BBA or a blood pressure supplement pack. You see a pack, it is a whole trial, and I'll be recommended say, what's the pack in it now? Is the pack in it now? You mean you're fashioning now? You see a double X nutrite, your all plant protein, or a big five now. If you are not the back of your sitting E nutrite, you are CoQ10 nutrite, which is coenzyme 10 nutrite, you are iron folic plus, so you are garlic nutrite, you are the vitamin C account, which is what partner, which is a 10 product, which will be to me a boy, blood pressure, and aquafunkra, or a bayon normal. If you see the back, if you have a system, I in a day attract him that it also will fight there 2-3 times. Let us say, with me, I sort it out the system, immune system, will boost it up, maybe behind it, higher fine. You see, at £345.70. It will weigh me in the next week. In the affair, will be our impotency, and as a bar will be here, I will announce a baby's out with me. And I'll be into your market, so into you, and I say, you see, when the product I obey in a day, until I am not guaranteed. So I never can you put that in the way, but you have started a boy in Kakaka every week.
Fantastic. Yeah, that was CP. Inti ene, wa mayati ya se diabetes. Mo wa paki wa honu ma, amamfu yusua, ebiti mi abuwa wa mo. Na yes. Osa mayati ya se se, adia no, o ta, nwa to the whole package. Enye se wotubi na wejebi. Enye se ana, ebrio no, en complementi each other. Inti therefore, no, it will not become effective. Inti no, etie for sana etie, unse ya se bema die, ujaria, na wa shasi entem, na wenye koko entem. And yes, I did not want to say, open so you, open so be you. You have to be committed to it and do it. And you know, yeah, that was it for any blood pressure. And also, so what can I ask money? Very, very important. Next week, obesity, other staff about, and also, obekam wasim. This week, so, so, what about modding, eddy, with details, you know, at the comment section, how am I? Ti wiki bia so no ayana odi atoha maye ana enkrofo ebusapa anti no wo ape information bia no wo comment section na scroll it up and you will be able to see it anti na very very important aha sana eti anti Mr. Ishan ye da wasipi for your continuous support to what we are doing and the education that we are bringing to the Ghanaian community. Sometimes no ana people don't realize say there are so many people behind who are also doing wonders behind the closed doors. I am just the vessel. I'm just the face. But believe in me, there are so many people every week. But almost also play very, very important and significant role in what we are trying to do and what we are trying to achieve. And most also, the hidden faces. Mwina ye damase pa for your continuous support. Sem kase mi bodi ya, edi ni mebo ami mi yeda. Ma mi suye chui yikasa, ma mi bedu, ma ma boat. Jese ni pane dosan, you know, countless. You know, akra jomo. Eni pane dosan, eni pane dosan. Enti ni adi amiti mambobu ni dini nina. But they know themselves. Ana mi nini se, they also appreciate. He say, we do appreciate what they are doing. So, sana mi mihu yase. And you know, sometimes we say we be on a medawasi. NHS we appreciate what the person is doing, but sometimes the person's conduct enough is more than enough. And you know, sana if you are seeing it here. And Mr. Sean, you're that was CP. And you know, you best say akasa next week. You're calling in the Paradise City for some question. Come 2 minutes. Be now here. Activate the telephone lines. You know, yami inshallah. Okay. Sana etie Mr. Ishan. I'm with product. Or no, so na. Yete ninkano. Yeko Paradise City. Yene omso kwa chen kwa moka krebi. Na afi yebie amatrofo no idea. Atu na afi no. Yetimi idea. Ansa mo telephone calls na mamu. Na yose. Amam for free. Mbata abu. I'm leaving for the young and the old, the blind and the deaf and the dumb, as you know I'm Yes, like the song say, we are living for the poor. We are living for the poor. People want to build houses in Ghana. You send money home, people chop it. You send money to your family members, they group up, they gang up, and they chop your money. When you go and you make noise, you become the victim. You become the bad person. They will badmouth you. How arrogant you have become because you live in Europe. You live in the Babylon. You know, but Paradise City say they are there for the voiceless. They are there for the poor. They are there for people who want to own their own houses in Ghana. So that you don't go through these difficulties, these family shenanigans, for families to chop your money. So Paradise City is here for the poor. When I say poor, it doesn't mean someone who doesn't have money, but poor, someone who does not have a good representative in Ghana to be able to build their houses for them. For that reason, Paradise City was born. And Paradise City is a solution to your building projects in Ghana. Madam PC, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, lawyer.
Nah, it is a...
Bacho nyamia dom boko pa uswe.
Nyamina dom boko mumpaibo enti tembiano yenama yinsuru. Nyakupa mwa mwadin wama yinyansa enwana yedinam ibiasia yewumi. Musuma da Roma Paradise City. Ene yaba Ghana inya baby di yetito. Yankoda ubi fiye biyem ani yankoda hotel biyem. Yenim se, se de amoye yebison yasono. Mobeye ama ibi ason amanse nyina aso. Enti ene, Madam Paradise City. Edena woma yetie fo.
Yo laya, neta sepa. Se mo de bi laye kano. I se privilege se ya bana it's me. Presenting our program now, so to all the listeners, so in church obia the buy actually the whole honum and see we just abba say we are still there. I know Kofor still here places to go. I was say omu here dying, omu here properties. Maybe I can property is a very good thing to have. And yet, scanning also on your property, on your prestige, a necessity. I said, well, I'm planning, you know, I'm making decisions here. It's me taking your life. It's me, ma, all these blood pressure. Ne, nyama nyama, kohaya, Mr. Shen, Babak. It's a very big factor causing a lot of death. And to know a toy, I must say, but you're going to this business. Naya Bua and Kofor Senebeya, Omobits me and your die or Ghana. Totally stress free. In constant communication with the BIA, very flexible, and to know whichever way able to do, no, you know, Kasana is possible, by all means, you bring a dying amount, a 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom, or one more, even 4-bedroom, as well, one more, and to now, if say a tearful, and who say, as well as the BIA kind of legal issue, no, almost solving, no. Or other aspect now, or try to bring it up for them, you know. And I want to know, it's me a boy with a dance, you know. It is a big girl of a dying, 1% of the Hano. Now, send out canoes, you have 4 days with that only representative, yeah, and that's 1% of the people who say, but to them, they're just between on any company, you know, or percent of the super force who are fine, a very flexible according to senior customer, and pay your Hano must say, yeah, winning say a beboa, you see, and then media basse, and ne.
Thank you very much. Said the Musi City, you know, Paradise City, they are willing and they are able to deliver your bespoke houses in Ghana and in particular Tema Community 25. Ah, Chesi Bibia Air Koso Ewo Honama. Now, if we are saying, Anna Yekano, say we investing in property, you will never lose. Oh dear, say we go Ghana krana, baby, a wage no, we bet media rent it. Oh dear, be a bank account or ho, international bank account. Any pani tima, we say every month be an offer cotton. What say abroad krana, you can check it up. So on yes, I feel now we go Ghana, be an offer now we pay scar go Ghana. We go Nesca no, a bo eda ho. Okay, what could DBA now want to know? So down when you have a and TV as silly as you can be. You bet maybe I see a discount when you be a new D. Mamma, yes, I will soon start because who will wage a war? I must say, you said you're solo more kind or see the honey pan, say, ne bre a chin yan or Babby. I must say, you said you're quasi be a baby dinner. And two TV as here who make you money enjoy small wine before you die. It is an area senator. Will you be a DB? Nay, free. Because Sabio said you, Ujanawa. We bet you see the Dino. Now, because I say we're working. Obi, we. Obi, and I didn't offer see the dear dear. None offer not our cabby. Anna Carno is soon popa. Obi, and offer any bedia dear, no offer see the dear dear. Or control a can in him, offer an air wound, and a me dinner. And 2 years can I also dibi wati, yes, we be dini dama. And in a Paradise City, also ever ho say, they will help us in investment, especially if you invest in mortar, you can't go wrong. Because Anyang your crowd, they wait me to rent it. So when you say 2 years, we have a Ghana, what do you rent it 2 years, sir? Independent tour, oh, we'll be a CC, mama. Oh, quiet, oh, we'll spend 1 week, 2 weeks, sir. Now, how they are renting, once a Jawaba, oh, we'll connect scanner. A bonus said bede, not just say when your home feelings. Now we deep, that's why you're free. And sana etie. And in a Paradise City, yeah, the masipi. Na say obi be se offer the number betuja. Not just say we so offer with me a contact you. Kede me depa.
But your number near +44 333 011 7724 +44 333 011 7724 WhatsApp ni mobile see a +44 790 847 5802 +44 790 847 5802 But your website say www.paradisecitygh.com.
www.paradisecitygh.com. Meet me at our website or at our check it or more up. Now, dear Ed Dewo, you know, said, dear, a good crowd or Paradise City project. And I say, meet me, I'm a family members. You can, they can make arrangement. Gawuta Ganama, you know, Gani Gani. You can go there and check it out yourself. The wonderful work that they are doing at Community 25 in Tema, Ghana. Ghana, so there, they say, yes, I'll continue in the middle of a city. There be, so to be called outskirts, Kakrano, who say, quality of life, no, it's brutal. Because in the middle, no, pollution, noise, is not good. And to be a bit, say, Tema, say, okay, Sean, my master, who no be any assem, you know, and you know, it's a good area to locate to. And to know, you're home all day, now you're rushing. Because very soon, no, and yeah, their price no more ton ubinya because me and customer sugar compare more price any other places, and you could see so more price not a very reasonable. You get the same quality into Paradise City. You more your homeboy in Iron Rush it before it is too late. Sana etie. Now they tear in a crowd paradise. Do you want to go and live in hell? No, we all want to go and live in paradise. And in our Paradise City, yeah, the Masipi in Yami in Shamo. I feel you may be a matrofa not in telephone line, no? Ubi a uwa question, biano, also ubeti me idea, ubeti me afre, na ya take him a phone calls. Na amount for a fre, certainly name me a phone line, no, and two. And in our yen take one of two phone calls, na yen feju me dear, no, emrande we, and we say, we have gone on for about 2.5 hours, time, no, I a big a crack, but. Sometimes, you know, if you need to bring quality to your people, you have to make that sacrifice. And you know, what episode free be on also a bit me afraid. This is the time, maybe phone lines, no idea at all. And you know, Monfrey, you could so a chairman phone call. The number, no, or say is the deposit to that counts. You know, I will say to you, they say, ring them up or ring them up. Also, be any circumstances, say, with which your depositor that would then mean say, interest arbitrary, no, a less. And you know, deposit on how much you want to pay, no, I may say it will depend on you as well. And you know, what do you fray woman? You know, what I'm saying. Be an in the case and will be an innocent. It's a problem. Number 64, you are live on Facebook. Hello, Patrick. What do you say?
I'm a
problem. I'm not a free. Patrick, Yantini, you're so a free.
Manchester.
Okay, Kwabna Yanko, I didn't even tell you your money.
Patrick, I'm a person who sat me with education. Look at Rana. If you want to be in your country, I'm a Bahani. If you want to be a Bahani. Maybe some of not try to buy it. You said to me, "I'm going to do it." I'm going to do it.
Okay. The whole kind of me and repeating, I mean, you making sure said the whole kind of meeting here. Who say who you uni? I know a big room. Who you? Ah, okay.
On the grounds of family ties,
what's it want me to improve family relationship or not?
Yeah.
And there you have to be able to prove it. And yes, any juma. This will be your offer. I assume we say, or ye, Abia, O mammy, Inia, and I'm a boy. O papa, Inia. And to your papa, Inia, what you need in a say, O birth certificate. Ah, a chair say, O papa, your papa. Anna, O papa, birth certificate. Anna, O offer, no birth certificate. So what means, Annie Maria, a link you up as family members. And to a important so being as idea. And yes, as so, get that and get DNA as well. What's your DNA so to prove the family relationship?
Okay.
So, and saying that what prove relationship, no, you also need to prove, say, you are financially dependent on your uncle. And no, they will need evidence, actually, say, on no, basically, will provide you with financial support before you came. Any application in your successful because anona a year condition, it comes with conditions. As a so be your family member, there have to be financial dependency and also a membership of your household. And since I want to prove it to you now, application will not be successful, unfortunately.
Number two, relationship, not financial wise, no. How will I prove it? I didn't mean to. I saw a man miscarry regularly, and I said, I don't know. I really said, on the customer account, and I said, it's
okay. What it is, and they say, Home Office will be looking at, say, well, uncle, and before so, baby, crew, more animal. Not or shell. And he said, I'm with another EU country. I don't know which country it is, but maybe I'm
on a different country. I'm to a different country.
Oh, okay. And you know, basically, you need to prove, say, financially, no, you are dependent on him, and also you are a member of his household. And he said, what's a different country, Kraana? As you prove, say, baby, and I want to know. On a nepia dineka, and I say, any fee and I want to know. So, and therefore, in your tenancy agreement to show, say, you have to say, you are Belgium, or tenancy agreement, so on a high dino or Belgium, mao. And now, or what evidence, such as any near my for, also near my for honor. That will be evidence of. A membership of household, and in terms of financial dependence, you know, Home Office normally prefer bank statements showing say or transfers can ever account to. If for whatever reason you cannot provide the bank statements, you have to be able to explain yourself and convince them as to why in tia it was not necessary to put the money in your bank account.
Okay. Now I find any place where mom was supporting me. So there was no need to say, yeah, maybe no more financial. And I even here in the cinema, In fact, I only take money from him and all that.
Okay, put it this way. If that is the case, how can your application I won't succeed? They will refuse you. And that means that angle, no? MWOW. So you probably have to start looking for alternatives. Because you want to be clearly, you want to be satisfy requirement, you know. Once satisfied, so I am farm out. But just what you must say.
That's the last one. And that's all. You say, be a financial wife, but she needs some sort of counter with you. I don't know. Make me, for now, make some money to my account and get to get anyone financial.
And you're too late in the sense to say they will go back some more because the financial dependency have to be continuing. And yes, baby application, yeah, now the evidence because I'm financially dependent on him. They will say they need past evidence to show I say you are financially dependent on him. And you know, and then Emma, this type of application is difficult, you know, for people to succeed. Okay, that's it. Okay, thank you. Bye bye. Okay. Eja ajene die eko ti osu ubetimi idea afre. Oh, question biana osu ubetimi idea afre. Number no once again is 075389. The number is 075389695 89. Osu ubetimi idea afre. Your bare 5 minutes to go. I may say time no ya tina ha amana broso empo and tino also ubitini idea afraid. And tia kemo call any question about immigration and nationality law topic that we've talked about today, or any question about immigration nationality law at all, ubitini afraid, we'll be happy to answer that for you. If you program na MC telephone, you best switching off your and you be bra SA koye normally no you program no no and na enko for air free. Oh yes sana sadi and yet me entertain be sana your time. It's been, you know, consumed. Tebestream will pay. If your program, I mean, first will boost a question because so friend, you're diabetes. You're going to switch your phone off. But you'll be able to find 5786. Hello.
Yeah, hello. Good afternoon, lawyer David.
Hello, good afternoon. Now, but you're doing the same like a free.
Your friend, Kwesi, Mikasa, every Birmingham.
Kwesi from Birmingham, your uncle.
Yeah, right. My part of the application. Emma, my office, EA family permit. Now, I'm refusing, you know, I'm my two reasons. Your DNA, your friend is saying, okay, my friend said DNA is a relationship, you know, and then birth certificate. And now, financial dependency, you know, so the mobile money, email receipts, and the call. Now, I'm going to say, there is nothing from him or no organ, no, said Ninsa Aka Sikano. Number two, almost say, Idia entered the family circumstances. They want evidence about his family circumstances. And Sana, you know, if they have to, they wouldn't. Maybe, sir, say, then you pay because mobile money no.
Yeah.
Eco mobile phone so.
Yeah.
Yeah, the ne school fees receipt edicar mobile money no. One of the payments actually for over 3 years. Nina ne edit your fees no. Can I make a little bit of advice?
Okay. The more part you said. In terms of the family circumstances, you know.
Yeah.
Emrani say. Dependency must be a dependency of necessity, not a dependency of choice. And therefore, no, under normal circumstances, no, abrochile die, uba, you as the parent, no, you are responsible for your own child. And you will be nemeshe Obama. That is the Western culture. They don't understand it from African point of view.
Okay.
It is your responsibility. And in their minds, they are thinking, say, Akrani papa, eno mame wo hin. Adentina omuntimi show muba. Na wona wo kwa ko show no. This is what they are saying to themselves, but they are not telling you. And you know, we need to be able to find a reason as to why in here his parents cannot provide for their own child.
Right.
And why it has become necessary for you to step in as an uncle to provide for your nephew or your niece. Patro, what I want to say. And to a B example, they say, hey, Bia, I can't mammy no papa. And in that case, you know, you need a death certificate.
Right.
A B A crani papa or more injury B, they cannot work. You need medical records. A B A jumana or more yenya and your meaningful job will be omunti minyes kebia. A B A ni pay slip. Unya £10. Mammy £10. And so omudi. Omuya day enya bi de share or moba. And therefore no, if they don't have the means to provide for their own child they are, then as an uncle no, it has become necessary for you to step in and provide for them.
Okay.
Mpacho wati asie oho no. It is an alone it here, but omono, they will never explain it to you. Because opinion bi kan sem bi chire me. O si German embassy. Omo wo idea bi say. Se wo ka chire gan ni say onko pesa man ko to dwe kra ma obenye bi aba. Onto won kan chire. So, entino sana etie. Entino omo e disguise the reason no. Entino so to me say assignment ni they are fine. In terms of say with this kind of common akra no e dey na chere say akra no ensa kenska no I don't know how it works in Ghana, but I suspect to say with this kind of common obi a ono so so nya email and aso nya text message
onya text message na you know we born short code no accessing account no okwa or the chair no omo iska na ma no.
And to me, you know, money receipt and
that be a more receipt or more no documentary evidence.
Okay, and in this case, you know, I will suggest to say a beer over company. You know, now, come explaining how the process works because Home Office don't understand. Maybe I mean, I don't know how it works, and you're so working. I can mean, so and yes, I saw a receipt in text message in a common phone to say the money has been it is there for
it's
collection.
Yeah.
And I want to say, so maybe I should be a text message. You said the money has been collected.
Yeah. And not and that the win, but I'm not send email say so and so and so. You sent, you know, maybe £100 to so and so and so. The money has arrived in the person's MTN mobile account. The DIN number, Sikano reference, transaction number. Idea, I'm not the bread. Yeah, you send the message, you know.
Okay, and who printed no can who ana?
Yeah, me deny na over 2 years. Me deny na can who?
Any area a possible say inipa na anshe. And he say, oh, your application now. You need to explain how the process work. Because if I tell you say judges no, a bit nim calling card. They don't know how it works. If I tell you, will you believe it? And he tell me, yes, we have to explain it to the judges. I say it is the cheapest way to communicate. And therefore, a lot of people in the diaspora use that method. And this is how it works. You dial a number, which is 0800 number, and then they will connect you to the number that you are trying to call. And to therefore, say, when you have a telephone bill, now, I tell my calling issue, you know, and if I have a friend, hey, show also.
Yeah.
Most judges don't know because many will be foreign. And to therefore, when you have a foreign call, sir, obey them how it works. And you're possible. And sometimes, you know, we must never assume we say they know or they must know. Trust me.
Okay.
But they say anybody ignorant, and therefore you need to school the person.
Right.
I said, for example, in Ghana, OYA application in Ghana. Yes, it is true that parents have responsibility for their children. But as a an uncle who's, you know, maybe you have been fortunate enough to be in a position to support the family, you know, it has become your responsibility because the parents do not earn enough. This is how much they earn. If you have evidence, fantastic. Some yourself employed a per accountant, non prepare financial accounts, Emma Omo, now on your Omo income and expenditure to show, say, Sikana Omo Geno is never enough to be able to look after the child. And therefore, it has become necessary as an uncle to step in and provide. Now accommodation akra ni tim kra no ebi a wona rent ya ma akra no and we do a tenancy agreement in so something like that esa now you are able to basically cover that problem. But you say, clear what you say,
yeah, 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 yeah,
yes, sir, yeah, that was it.
Mammy, sir, but me, because
you're confused,
obviously. Now, okay, for say, yeah, appeal, but doing a second application and seeing with this advice, no, hopefully,
yes, why.
That's
yes, sir, that was it. Now, MSM, my mission, Pika say it to you. And you know, Debbie, you can't see, you see, Medasi Bibri, and Kanisa.
Hey,
you can't Medasi P.
Medasi P.
That's right. Because, okay, okay, Medasi Bibra, what the Babro Fuma, and you thank you very many. Now, I said, Medasi P, yeah, and you thank you very much.
All right.
Ovid Bovichre. Yeah, that's it. All right, bye bye for now.
Bye.
Hello, 8225. What be Drew?
Hello, good afternoon.
Also, good afternoon.
Here, sorry. Hi, afternoon, the evening. Sorry, not for me. I'm quite with the media program.
So, Enyashi. Now, but you didn't say that I'm free.
I'm
free.
I'm
free.
I'm free. Last time we throw about divorce. What's it online? The boss fee, who can set me to check it? The boss fee is 550.
That's right.
But now I'm saying, the boss fee is Ghana, and I was thinking, I'm not going to be able to say anything. I'm not going to be able to say anything. And I'm not going to be able to support me, and I say, I'm not going to be able to do it anymore. And I'm not going to be able to say anything, because I'm not going to be able to na me kwai wa ru su su odia ejino be se se anyway bia mi ya adwuma de ba pa time me dey benefit and I'm more health issue kaka ejino anyway bia ba se ha support me with the fee na na.
Okay, this country, they always have exemptions. If you are in serious financial situation, you could apply for fee exemption at the court. Okay. The court have to approve it before you can go ahead and get the exemption. As to whether you'll be successful or not, it's a question mark, because these days, you know, government doesn't have money. And what can say, we said that government doesn't have its own money. The government get money from the people through taxes. But to be an idea, you can try. If you are lucky, it may be granted. If you are not lucky, they will simply say government support is enough for you to do savings and pay for your own divorce, or you get the other party to contribute, which in this case, you know, he doesn't want to contribute. So yes, there is a way. That means you make an application for fee exemption.
Okay.
Oh yes, your income and expenditure, any money that you get, your bank statement, meaning that they will look into it.
Okay.
And make the assessment.
Oh, okay. And I'm a free lawyer or a man, and I just am from my own lawyer, because to be honest, I'm not sure for financial, I don't open with any issue. I'm a lawyer.
I'm a charity.
I'm
a charity, sir. They may be able to help people like yourself, but
okay.
These days, you know, it's going to be very difficult, because legal aid do for you on the phone, but also. At the end of the day, you know, the government doesn't have money, unless say you get lucky. Now, you'll be in your legal aid amount. And you know, honestly, I don't know too much about that, but you can keep ringing around and see whether you'll be able to get someone who'll be able to help you through the legal aid system. But legal aid, you know, at the moment, is a mess. I know that, I must say. But try your luck and see what happens.
Okay.
All the best.
Yeah,
okay, thank you. Okay, yanko fa ya mame sunya twi kasa wa try se obi rema soso no tam obi free bia na che se obi soso ejina so aha ti na yanko na yanko fa mame yesi panyini enu fi adue na panyini soso edware wi a na che se efie ensu aide asa enti ade mame be ka akiri na che se ye ti do de bre me mame ba be pon ye ye tam na so na enti fa dwumadie no ebra na wiye. Mame de ekromwa ono ade mame ono ana oso yesa enkatrankatrankakra ye chia no na otena emaye enti no ye mame nyame enshira na me mu se de ye so ye besi adawase
Justice and law, and divine imprint, and
Sadia, not just say, ye did you, my dear, no, ever near ye.
But to you, Nacobin, nineteen or tittle. But some may kind of send me down with me, I say, me do additional. Bring ya, ebay. Mumma, a buy and chance of buying them, she should be my aim. Not ye, you see, I drink, but to castle, Mr. Common Sense Christmas, and ye be dinner. Sabino, a beam, Sir Munko, come and foot. Ah, na watch you, Nasa Chilin, so you know you are now a day, ain't you? And you serve a common sense Christmas. Me say, made a VIP prison. In that prison, VIP, me and I may have a person with me, them, cobby, be a TV dinner, me jam. Mommy and Sharon, so you know, you have been young, yamil.
Amen. Mommy, yada was sippy. Yada was it, yada was it. Yamiadum. Yɛde dwumadie no so ɛba na awieeɛ obi biara watumi de to a yɛda m ase obi biara so bɛtie ne akyire yɛda m ase no woman no cry yɛda m ase yɛ maame maame si atwii kasa yɛda w ase ɛsɛ wafotuo ɛne your inspiration ɛne deɛ wo so yɛma community no nyame ɛnhyira wo bebree pii nyame ɛnhyira wo pii Obi ade to abi asoso nyame enhyira mo next week ye besa ehia bio nyame enka mo ho mama ba ye besa ehia bio we ada ko justice and law solicitors makramu until we meet again next week etina mama ba ye telephone number ehye 0207 993-5976 Your mobile number 07538-969-589 Say upe so be here Monday to Friday Book appointment Nebe Kunye Mami Enka Munyama We are based at Unit 35B The link 49 FR Road Brixton, London SW2 1BZ Macramo, Nami Ishram in the house.
Your little darling, don't shed no tears. No woman, no cry. Said, I remember when we used to sit in the government yard, entrenched down. I'm gonna make everything's gonna be alright.